he is an absolute rock star of the current culinary scene, and last week Josh Niland was crowned Best New Talent at the Gourmet Traveller Restaurant Awards. He's a seafood expert and he's here to whip up some fresh finds from the ocean. Please welcome Josh Niland from Sydney. Yay! Welcome. It's funny that we call you the Best New Talent because you've been doing this a long time.
Yeah, this year's 14 years. So wow. Even though I look 14.
You were 14 when you started?
15. So I'll be 29 in a month or so.
How did you start where?
Newcastle, so Hunter Valley, so from Maitland originally, and then I worked in a restaurant in Newcastle, and then 17 I moved to Sydney by myself and, worked in some real kitchens. So.
And now you've got a restaurant, your own restaurant, yeah, which is fantastic.
Wife and I own our restaurant in Paddington on Oxford Street.
Fantastic.
So, yeah, all fish.
And what are you making for us?
We are doing Flinders Island calamari, so this guy here, very alien-esque. Ooh. So I thought I'd bring what it actually looks like and then what we're actually going to be playing with. I can show you how to clean it up. It'll only be a sec. We can start with the hood, basically, and then your legs, and all you need to do is just pull. Morning viewing. And then... So this is in all the squids.
It's his backbone.
Basically the backbone, yeah, but it's almost like plastic. So
What do you do with that?
Well, if you clean it up, you can use it as a vehicle for a canapé if you want to get really interesting, but nothing much.
And have you got some squid ink on your fingers as well?
I do, and I luckily have a towel over here. Pardon me.
Okay. Now listen, should you wash that?
So washing fish and washing any shellfish is the worst thing that you could do to it.
Right.
So washing anything seafood orientated starts to break it down, and it starts to actually promote the smells of fish that aren't so nice.
That I can't stand.
Yeah, that's right. So anyway, so that's our squid, and that's the best way to pull the gut out.
So no washing, no smell.
No washing, no smell, and
I find that amazing.
Even washing fish. You shouldn't do that. Just keep it dry, wipe it with a paper towel, and that's the best course of action.
No one has ever said that to me.
Yeah, keep it dry.
Yep.
So this is interesting. So we've got the calamari tube.
Yep.
We've got a long palette knife. We put the palette knife inside, this, and then have that on the left-hand side if you're a right-hander, and then go along with your knife and cut to the palette knife. You can go as thin or as thick as you like. If you go nice and thin, then the heat travels through it nice and quickly, and it cooks the squid really evenly.
And then it's going to be nice and tender.
That's right.
Because that's the tricky thing with cooking squid, right? That it can become really
like a rubber
chewy,
boot.
Really cool. Yeah, like a rubber boot. That's right. So, Denise, you were asking before, should you soak the squid in milk?
Yes, because, a lot of people say it tenderises it,
right.
But you say no.
I think kiwi fruit gets thrown around as well, doesn't
kiwi
it?
Kiwi fruit?
Does it?
To tenderise and... but no, don't do that. but that's our squid slinky now, so...
He looks pretty.
And that's a wonderful one to have pre-prepared for, friends coming over for a barbecue and, it's a really... it's quite an interesting technique.
Isn't
it is
it?
Fancy. So, I'm going to grab my towel again.
Okay.
But for the garnish, basically we've got a treviso, which are, around at the moment. And we're going to be cooking it in a pan, so we're not too worried about the mess. Take off the outers. Obviously, they're very bitter. They can still be used, though. And what you can do is just take out the majority of the white. It's nice to leave a little bit in because you do want a little bit of the bitterness.
Ooh. What are you going to do with that?
You can pull that apart. We're going to throw that in the pan. We're going to quickly kind of blister it.
Like a little barbecue-y type thing.
And then have you got anything in the pan at the moment? Just a super hot pan ready to go.
No, that's getting stinging hot.
Okay.
So I've got a little oil.
Now that seems nice and hot.
That's nice and hot. So we're going to put the treviso in. We're going to let this get nice and crispy. We're going to put a little salt in. Because salt plus bitter equals sweet. That's generally the rule of thumb. The more bitter something is, then you add the salt, it promotes a little bit more sweetness.
Oh, right.
So,
is that why I put salt on the lemons then?
Quite possibly.
Does that make
actually
sense? I love lemons, but I love it with a sprinkle of salt.
Well, preserved lemon, if you put the salt on the pith, obviously you're salting down whole lemons.
This is just a normal lemon.
Just a piece of lemon.
I just eat them.
Cool.
And with the
After
salt.
A tequila or?
Yeah.
No. No.
So we give that a little stir up.
Turn it over.
Yeah.
So lovely. You're really blistering this.
That's right.
Giving it a quick fry.
And we're going to put a few macadamias in that we've roasted already.
Roasted macadamias.
And then these are basically, they're called muntries. They're basically a native apple.
Bush tack.
They're emu apples. So
what
we've done is just put a basic pickle over them. So it's white wine vinegar.
Sugar.
Yeah, go for it. It's got more antioxidants in a muntree than a blueberry. So it's good for you.
Are they nice or are they sour?
They're tart.
They're tart.
No, vinegar.
Yeah, pickled. So we've put that in there. And you're doing a great job. Bit of pepper. And we're going to tip that out into the bowl.
Gee, that's quick. Yeah. I can smell the pickly, onion.
And now we're going to put a little bit more oil in.
Mm-hmm.
And we're going to go ahead and we're going to cook some of these legs that we have. The legs of the squid.
Legs 11.
So at the restaurant, we really focus on making sure we don't put anything in the bin. Hence why we've done this dish today, is to show off the fact that you can take that whole squid and you can use every single part of it.
Well, they do everywhere overseas, don't they?
That's
they don't
right.
waste anything.
Yeah. No, it's just you need to make the food texturally pleasant for us, like for Australians, for, you know, a Western palate. So avoiding things that are kind of creamy or too, you know.
Look like they're still alive.
And they really won't take very long at all. We'll put a little bit of salt in.
I've learned something. I'm so glad that you taught me today about not washing the fish.
Yeah.
Because that gives it the smell.
Yeah.
Well, isn't that amazing?
I mean, really water comes out of a tap at between 16 and 18 degrees, you know, so it's already starting to break down the protein. And, I mean, then you put it into your little domestic fridge, which your, you know, roommate will be opening and shutting all day. And
look at it, little, it's gone all blistery.
All its suckers are going blistery.
We're going to fry this sucker up and plate it up and taste it after the break. Do not go anywhere. Perfect. We are cooking with Australia's new best chef. See you soon. Josh Niland is a name you need to know. He is Australia's best new chef, and he's been cooking up some amazing calamari for us this morning.
And I have to say, there is no fish smell whatsoever.
It smells good, doesn't it?
Incredible. Yeah. It's actually incredible.
Just run us through very quickly what you did.
So what we've done our little sauté of the legs and the radicchio and the macadamia and the muntries. So that's all very sweet, sour, bitter, salty, yummy. And then over here, which we haven't talked about, is all the other bits of the squid, we roast off in a pan at the restaurant, and then we make like a sauce out of it. So it's an
ink sauce.
Yeah, it's an ink sauce, but it's a little more roasty. So we'll put a little bit of that down first, just because it's delicious.
What does it taste like?
It's like, it kind of heightens what a squid
newspaper.
Tastes like. It's newspaper,
salty.
That's right.
It's very salty, isn't it?
Yes, it is, if you buy it out of the jar, because a lot of those jarred products are salted to preserve it.
Mm-hmm.
According to that story we did.
So we've just built that up nicely, and then, you know, this guy over the top.
Check that out. How fancy is that?
It looks so pretty. It looks so pretty.
Yeah. That's it. Who wants to taste? Who wants
me.
To taste? Jessica Rowe.
Jump in.
You can have some too.
I'll duck
Please
around.
You can have some.
Josh from St. Peter Restaurant in Sydney, you are an absolute superstar.
Thank you.
We are all going to have a taste of this. Check it out.
There's no delicate way of eating ink.
Oh, yum.
Yum. Double thumbs up to you, Rowe.
That's beautiful.
As well, everyone in our studio audience today is going home with a copy of Gourmet Traveller.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. 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 Yeah.